Hello, greetings, my friends. This is Gilles Mancillon. I've been a bit tired because I received some amazing news from spirits and kept me up most of the night. I was just so engulfed in this wonderful potential and possibilities and certainty of what that which is to come. The card of the day is the time of the nap. So I'm going to take a nap after this video. It's about resting, relaxing. The slower we go, the faster it will manifest. And we need to understand how things work. In the old 3D world, in the world, the old world, we knew how it works. There's millions of videos that tell you, if you want to do this, you got to go this way. If you want to do that, you got to do this way. It's about action, efforts, fighting for what you want, and all kinds of thing, determination. When in the new world, it's about flowing with the flow, about connecting first to the divinity within, and from that standpoint, allowing things to manifest in relationship to the will of God. Which is, it does not require effort, it requires letting go, it requires acceptance, it requires faith, it requires trust, it requires positive action, without interference, to think positive, to speak positive, and to act positive, regardless of what is to come, and to be gentle with everything that comes to you. For we do want a decree in the name of God, but the decree in the name of God is only valuable when we connect to our divinity, and we can be the instrument of that will. For it is us; we have the power to do that, and so we're going to be moving forward. It is important to stand at zero point, to be at zero point always, to stand. There is no time, there is no space. There is just zero point where all things are right now, and there is an eternal transmutation. Everything is transient anyway, so it's about. It's about connecting to the higher consciousness of our higher self, and to know that God already knows. God knows the past, He knows the future, He knows what's to happen tomorrow, He has planned things for like tomorrow, 1 month, 1 year, 100 years, 1,000,000 years. He knows all that, and that's His plan. No matter what anybody does, God will have His way. Yet He always is able to move through in the now. He only lives in the now. With the adaptation to the free will of humans, given the law of cause and effect, but He has so much resources that He can really handle that with a great deal of ease. For the plan of the universe of universes, is the great project of God. It is magnificent, but it's a project. And when God has started, He doesn't need to rewind it and to He can do anything, whatever is necessary. He's fully master of all things in the universe. But and soon humanity will come to realize the greatness and power and the beauty and mercy of the Creator. But for Him, it's really easy to deal with all that, and He doesn't need to. It's a self-generating energy. It's like it will never end. God has never stopped since the universe was created. The universe has not stopped its progression. So it is an eternal project, and God has the power also to put aside any darkness. When you have anything that is dark, or negative forces, you can ask your Creator just remove it. It will remove it. He has the power to do that. And so it's a matter of consciousness. For we want truth and justice to be manifested in the world. We want to think about the after. Madness of 2021. So we want to already find the solutions, already envision the world, what needs to be happening from the executive standpoint of on the governance level to make the better environment, to create better quality of life, greater education, greater health, greater prosperity, more quality of life, joy, what brings you joy. For there's a lot of world leaders that are not bringing joy to their people. That hasn't been the program. But now we need leaders that bring joy and educate, for it is all about education, self-empowerment, for it is when people will lead, those who lead have the responsibility that they create leaders, they don't create followers, they rather create leaders. So it's like there is an ebullition, a renaissance of sorts. For a lot that is to come is going to be on a need-to-know basis, not about spiritual ascension and spiritual. It used to be like that. Spiritual, all the esoteric teachings used to be only for the initiated, but now it has to be open to the whole of humanity. But what's going on the earth plane is really on a need-to-know. If somebody doesn't need to know, there is no need for that person to be informed. So it is very important to trust and to let go of all the media hypnosis, not even listen. You don't need to know those things. It's not for you. It will unfold naturally. If there's something important for you to know, God will let you know. The people will let you know. But really be careful even on the internet. not to spend any time. You don't need to believe that you have to follow up on the drama that is going on. It will, until we're fully empowered, and it won't affect us. But we all have the role to play here, and we need to play it all the way to the end. For God has already set up all that, and the soul, our soul, set up all of the state of our life. The highest wisdom from the angel is to listen. You have to listen, to really be listening to what life is saying. For life is always talking to us. Like Descartes used to say, the philosopher, is that you can find as much wisdom with any conversation with anyone in any place in the world than in all the books of philosophy. Because when you tune into the great spirit of God within yourself, and the great spirit of God that is within other beings will respond to you and will teach you, and then you adapt to whatever moment by moment, even if you had a great idea, and God tells you, that's not a great idea. That's the better way of looking at it. You say, of course, well, you realize that he's right. And so be very much listening to what anybody is telling. There are certain things that are on the surface, but then there are also some deep communication and meaning in the exchange. What you need to understand is enthusiasm, to stay really positive, to stay really, to know that the freedom is near. There is this amazing, this equinox brought really, we just need to bring the balance, to keep the balance between the inner world and the outer world. In the past, the outer world was everything. Then we moved into spiritual awakening, the inner world was everything. And then now we need to balance it out so we can be divine inside and divine outside, and we can decree in the name of God that we want this planet to be free, to be healthy, to be where all the people can celebrate their life, and little by little to invoke the presence of that creator that will imply the whole company of heaven to be behind you, and we'll find they have magnificent being in the universe that have amazing attributes and power. We have no clue, even on the higher planes. There is always higher planes, and but those will can only come into play when they are called to do so. And so just continue to connect and tune in and listen to the voice, the call of the heart. What we need to do is love, continue to love, to expand your love. Love is happiness, love is sharing, love is just appreciation. It can be many, many things, but we continue to cultivate that love. And the outcome is clairvoyance. There's so much that is coming into the consciousness, like amazing, amazing realization and reality. So it's like, because we all exist somewhere in the periphery of God, no matter who we are, where we are. Some of them are farther, some of them are closer. Even the great spirits, all the spirits, the great spirits of the universe, they're much closer. They're closer to God because they're unified. But they still, we all mostly us on the human on the earth. We need to get closer to the center, and understand everything is already scheduled by the Creator. And so just trust that. Trust your soul and spirit, and just flow with the flow. Try to allow your inner voice to be. To be heard and to be appreciated. Well, I hope this message was interesting for you. I thank you very much for listening. It's a great honor to be able to communicate on those ideas and truths. And very soon the new book is going to start. And thank you for liking, sharing, commenting. And thank you for subscribing. Thank you for your donations. If you want a private session, you can send me an email. It might take me a couple of days to respond. But I do sense that with those news that Cyril brought to me is very, very exciting. So I'm very excited. I couldn't even sleep last night. There's so much going on. I'm going to finish with a song. It's a song that came out of the pile, so let's sing it. I'm not sure who sang it. I think maybe Buddy Holly. It's called originally, not Fade Away. It's called I'm Gonna Love You Night and Day. I'm gonna tell you how it's gonna be. You're gonna give your love to me. I'm gonna love you night and day. For love is love and not fade away. When love is love and not fade away. My love is bigger than a Cadillac. I try to show it to drive me back. Your love for me has got to be real. For you to know just how I feel. When love is love, not fade away. When love is love, not fade away. I am gonna tell you how it's gonna be. You're gonna give your love to me. I'm gonna love you night and day. Where love is love, not fade away. When love is love, not fade away. When love is love, not fade away. When love is real, it does not fade away. So I'm gonna pull one more card, just so that I come and see before my take a nap. Before I do feel it's time today to take a nap. For the card of the day is the magic, the miracle. For when the work is done, there is nothing much to do. You just allow. You just be like a flower receiving the sun and the rain and all those. It's just it's this beautiful experience, and we're very close to that. That point where all the difficulties are over is the card of the wheel, the Archangel Jeremiel, a brand new beginning. You are arriving at a turn, change of direction to access happiness. So it is very much, it is very, here is in levitation, it's watching the wheels go round and round. And so it is. It is very much about understanding also the cards, those mirror cards. They're always exactly perfect what we need to hear at the time. That everything is a reflection of spirit. When we come to realize that all is God, then only God talks to us, and then all the surface things becomes an interest, an education, a tool. But it's really the love of God that dominates all experiences. So it is important to continue to tune in, to refine ourselves, to do this little tweaking still needs to be done, but it will all unfold in due time. Thank you very much. Wish you a wonderful day, and I'll talk to you later. Namaste.